नमस्कार ब्रदर्स एंड सिस्टर्स, लेडीज एंड जेंटलमैन, ऑफिशियल्स, स्पोर्ट्समैन, स्कॉलर्स, स्टूडेंट्स, दोज़ हू आर लिसनिंग अराउंड द वर्ल्ड, आई वेलकम ऑल टुडे. We discuss respect is commanded and not demanded. Human society is a confluence of people belonging to different age groups, religious persuasion, professions, political inclination, sports, males, females, etc. Persons possessing good wealth, advanced age, political status, high position in business or profession are generally respected. However, they may fail to get the quantum of regards and adoration to their positions. They not only deserve the respect but start expecting more and demand gratitude from the society, which may be due to degradation in their character and behavior. So we give respect to every person according to age, status, etc., because respect begets respect. Develop full faith in your spiritual master. Practice regular meditation. Always speak truth. Become trustworthy. Respect all religions. Do not criticize any religion. Try to avoid worldly vices like anger, lust, greed, attachment, egoism. Give up base desires. Keep on trying progress, but also stay contented on present possessions. Help the needy and not the greedy. Keep on assessing your own performances. Try to realize various aspects of strength and weakness of character. Do not try to impose your will upon others. Try to give or donate something and do not demand. Never consume alcohol and any other intoxicant. Be polite in behavior. Be relaxed in your dealings with others. Avoid superstitions, hatred, falsehood, hypocrisy. Perform social service for the welfare of humanity. Never indulge in violence, theft, and gambling. Never indulge in nepotism and bribery. Do something which is extraordinary and distinguished act. Do not elaborate much on self-praise, but you can tell about your achievements. Feel good and explain the achievements of others in praiseworthy language. First deserve, then demand. Perform your duties sincerely, honestly, and with full dedication. Then only the rights can be expected. The person who deserves the regards has to do something additional, positive, and extraordinary. The associates and neighboring persons start realizing the goodness in the concerned person. Love thy nation. Always extend all possible help to the orphans and the needy. Never be envious to the progress, prosperity, and success of others. Maintain good health so that you stay independent and do not depend upon others for support. Always stay acceptable to the society through virtuous thought and righteous actions. Largeness and greatness is more important than just being large and great. Let the respect commanded has its perpetual and everlasting status so that its effect stays even after death. Attempts should be made to relieve tension and thus stay with relaxation. Do not get disturbed due to your criticism. Try to find out the cause and remove it. Perform self-appraisal or self-assessment of your points of strength and weakness. Develop good habits to eliminate shortcomings. A person, howsoever rich with elderly age, close relative, strong in physical body, or possessing power of administration, just cannot claim regards because of distinct rank. General masses may pretend to show certain gestures of superficial respect, but their regards are not heartfelt or deep-rooted. There may be certain sycophants who try to exploit the situation by exaggerating their status. Every person in the society requires certain level of respect or regards from childhood to old age. The respect cannot be conveyed in the form of words, salute, good gestures, or even submission. Offering the respect in the form of salute in different styles depending upon the tradition, convention, religion, or reason. If the desired level of respect is deprived, the reaction can be instant, delayed, subdued, or latent. The level of regards for parents, teachers, elderly persons, relatives, friends, youngsters, administrators, subordinates, spiritual guide, etc. is different. The reverence for spiritual guide is supreme and should be through the development of full faith, complete submission of thoughts and emotions. Nowadays, the trend of regards to the parents and guardians is declining, which is very discouraging. This is mainly due to increasing urge of independence among young ones. They do not wish to follow the old traditions of modesty and humility. Youngsters in the family or outside, the subordinates in the office should also be given due regards. The crux of commanding respect in the society comes through eloquent qualities of truthfulness, virtuous thoughts, righteous actions, good habits, strong character, and amiable behavior. So a man should be very punctual, regular for his own duties. What are the duties in his life? He should be very careful about his duties. Self-appraisal or self-assessment or introspection is the righteous way to lead a regulated, healthy, confident, and comfortable life. Let everyone of us introspect ourselves with the help of simple queries as: what is the purpose of human life? How it can be improved to enable us to live happily in harmony with nature? Ordinarily, people tend to work for attaining physical and sensual satisfaction. However, it alone does not satisfy them. The true sense of achievement comes only when one is able to help others in need, either through monetary help or service to alleviate the sufferings of the needy. This is important objective of human life, to be able to return in good measure back to the society and Mother Nature. In addition to the physical aspects, human beings need moral and spiritual uplifting. This can come through association with spiritual guide. The uncertainties of objectives in life may be removed only by interacting with the wise who have led a disciplined life in conformity with the natural laws and spiritual hope. The true benefits from the lives of refined souls can be drawn only if one imbibes the values cherished by our ancestors. Self-control and meditation become essential. These qualities help us in life. Various religions in the world advocate these qualities to regulate useful living. Human race is supreme creation of Almighty God. Each person has two major components, the physical body and the eternal soul. The body is considered more important for everyone. People spend a lot of time, energy, attention for its comforts and improvement. Varied costumes, makeup, articles, etc. are in great demand. Even fashion shows and contents are organized throughout the world to exhibit the means of decoration. Talents are attained in different fields of business, management, law, engineering, medical, games and many other areas, not only to earn but also to achieve commendable status in the society. Exercise and sports make the body fit and strong. Thoughts, imagination and actions of the body are regulated by mind, but according to various religious concepts, mind or man also nurtures and promotes wicked thought. It can be a mischievous and reckless entity. On the contrary, soul, the inner voice, is considered as a divine bliss. It not only gives serene and positive attitude, but also prevents the mind.